Welcome back guys to another Games I've Got This Month. This month is of course June, and I got quite a lot of PlayStation 3 games. I got a new hardware, and I even got some PlayStation 2 games. So let's start out with PlayStation 2. Finally I got Samurai Warriors, the first one. Now I got all the Samurai Warriors games on the PlayStation 2, and I hope the Samurai Warriors 3Z or Samurai End or Samurai Warriors 3 Extreme or Empire will come out in Europe for the PlayStation 3. But you know, Kui already said Samurai Warriors 3Z is not coming, they don't want it, and so hopefully Empire will come. But doesn't matter, Samurai Warriors for the PlayStation 2. I also got a game that is a budget title. It was from the Budget 2000 series from HTEC, and it's actually Monster Attack, and it's only available in Europe, but on the Xbox 360 there is also a remake of this game, and it's called Earth Defense Force 2017, and this is just a stripped down version of it. There are only like 25 levels, only 120 weapons, only like 10 types of enemies, and of course the Xbox 360 game is way better. Yes, I actually played that game till the end. I totally loved that game. I played it with my brother. I played this game too, and in 2 days I beat this game, but it was still a lot of fun. And of course I had to get it. It was only 10 euros and it's Gradius 5. It's a shmup, still sealed, I will let it sealed, because a long, long time ago, you know, even the time that I didn't have work, I had this game, I sold it, and it was kind of stupid because I totally loved this game. So now I got it back, the black, you know, the black edition, what they call it, you know, not the platinum version. Still sealed, I will keep it sealed, and it's definitely awesome to have. Now for the PSP, you guys knew I was really stupid. I sold kind of all my usable PSPs, so I got myself a new PlayStation portable. It's a black piano black. It was only 110 euros. So it was definitely 20 euros less than normal price, school device. And with that I of course got White Knight Chronicles Origins on the PSP. I played it a little bit and it definitely has this White Knight Chronicles feels, but at the moment I think I'm like 3 hours into the game, it feels more like you're doing quests. So it's not like a whole storyline like in White Knight Chronicles, it's more like you're accepting a quest and then a storyline goes on. But with the music, the battle system is actually faster than White Knight Chronicles. I actually prefer this battle system over that from White Knight Chronicles, because you don't see that circle bar. It's just you attack, and after the attack ends, you attack, and after the attack ends, you attack. So it is much faster. Of course, it's a dumped down version of White Knight Chronicles. It's not a remake, it's not a port, it's a totally new game. It sets 10,000 years before White Knight Chronicles 1. It's here, it's in the Dogma Wars. As I said, I'm only playing for 3 hours. I played a lot of quests to level up and stuff. Definitely an awesome game, and hopefully I will play it more. Now, of course, I had to get Tactic Ogres. Now, I actually wanted to, this is special edition. I always wanted to have this game when it was announced that it will come to the PSP, because I heard a lot of good things about it. But 40 euros I thought was really expensive. Now I got it for 24 euros. Totally sealed, totally new, Tactic Ogres, Let Us Cling Together, the special edition with the mini soundtrack and exclusive mini soundtrack, hardback 48 page cover, so it's definitely awesome. Still sealed by the way, because I'm playing other games. Now the games I am actually playing is Final Fantasy for the complete collection. It has this stupid thing, I hate this. I mean, it's like it flips hill all the time, and you have this, what is it, like some sort of card. It's sealed, so that's pretty cool, and you get a little cloth to wipe out your PSP system with the, I think it's the main character of Final Fantasy is 4. Here's some pretty cool artwork. The game itself is just here. It's kind of funny because it's a white version. I do have to say is that white really looks awesome. I always said to everybody, I think that the Wii DVD boxes look incredible cool. I just love the white, because you know, it doesn't matter if it's black or white, it always fits with a game. green for the Xbox. You know, I don't, the boxes kind of look ugly a lot of times. But doesn't matter. Final Fantasy IV, the complete edition, really awesome. I'm like 3 hours into it, really loving this game. Of course, it's an old school Final Fantasy game. And no, I never played the original. Now for the PS3, of course I got a lot of games. First I want to say is that I got Ninja Gaiden Sigma 2. Yes, indeed, I sold this game, but now I got it back. It was only 8 euros, so it doesn't matter, still sealed. But a game that I didn't have, but I always wanted, is Ninja Gaiden Sigma 1. That's definitely awesome. Never have this, had this game, and the Ninja Gaiden series is definitely awesome. Now, of course, this was the month of White Knight Chronicles 2. If you have seen my impression, I said a lot of good things and a lot of bad things about this game, and I'm kind of still into that. But I do have to say is that I am at the moment at the end of the game. The game is much easier now because I grinded a lot. I built up my arsenal, I built better armors, got better weapons, so I'm definitely much stronger now. Even though not overpowered, I mean, I still have like to hit 2 times an enemy, they fall down, but definitely more than sometimes 3 to 4 times. So definitely, White Knight Chronicles 2 is definitely an incredible, awesome RPG. The story is much, much better than White Knight Chronicles 1, even though I don't like the backtrackings. It's like doing the same thing over and over again, and there are, as of this moment, only 3 new areas, but they're pretty cool. Finally, I got it really cheap. It's MotorStorm Apocalypse. I actually played it one time, and I played like 11 levels, and the story is kind of funny. You know, it's like just, you know, guy who wants to ride in the MotorStorm festival, and he does. And I do have to say is that when I first saw it, I was like, no man, MotorStorm the desert version was awesome. MotorStorm Pacific Rift, I totally loved that game. But why in skyscrapers? But I have to admit, this is chaotic awesomeness. It is definitely a game I never played. It's, you know, you can say like Burnout or whatever, but this is totally different. It really is like the whole city is falling apart and you really have to dodge everything. And it's not like the game is saying, hey, in 10 meters you have to go left because a building is falling apart. They're saying nothing. You don't have any direction of where you can go. And so this is really an awesome off-road chaotic racer. Of course, this was also the month of Infamous 2. And just like White Knight Chronicles 2, I am at the end of the game. I only have to unlock one part of the island, and the beast is already in the city. I totally love this game. The powers are getting stronger, the powers are getting cooler. The story is getting more awesome. Even though the story isn't that great as in Infamous 1. I really thought the Infamous 1 story grabbed me more. I don't think that this story really grabbed me, but it's definitely awesome. I do like the new Cole. I do like the new voice actor of the new Cole. And yeah, like I said, the powers are awesome. There are a lot of things to do. And it's just, you know, it's Infamous, but bigger and better. Now, I also had to get Super Street Fighter Arcade Edition. Yes, I know I do have Super Street Fighter. Yes, I know there are only like 1 or 2 new game modes and only 4 new playable characters. But this is the thing, I can get the download version for 15 euros. For only 15 euros, I can get the download version. It's the half the price I paid for this because I paid 29 euros for this. But as you know, I rather put out more money to buy a physical copy than I would buy a download copy, so that's why I bought this version. Still sealed, haven't played it yet. Of course I will play it, but this is now my thing. You know, I rather buy a more expensive physical version than buy a digital version that I, there's nothing, you know, this is the digital version and this is the physical version, so that's definitely better. And the last game, I actually got it yesterday, and that is Dynasty Warriors Gundam 3. First up, I have to say is that I have no idea if this is the same developer team. I know it's from Koei and Namco Bandai, but I'm talking about the developing team as Dynasty Warriors 6 or the Dynasty Warriors games, because this game is totally different. First up, this game looks freaking awesome. It is a cel-shaded graphics. and it really, really looks good. Second, there is no frame rate issues, not a lot of frame rate issues, and really all is running really smooth, it plays really smooth. Thirdly, there are a shitload of enemies on screen. Sometimes there are like 100 or 150 units on screen and they don't pop up like in Dynasty Warriors all the time. So, looks better, plays better, looks way cooler, I have to admit, this game looks awesome, and have way, way more units on screen than Dynasty Warriors, even Dynasty Warriors 6. Why the hell are they not doing that in Dynasty Warriors 7? I have no idea why they're not doing that. Hopefully, this game will sell better than Dynasty Warriors, and hopefully, Tecmo Koei will think to themselves, Tecmo Koei will think to themselves, hey, Dynasty Warriors Gundam 3 looks better, plays better, has more units on screen. Why can we not do that in a Dynasty Warriors game or a Samurai Warriors game? But definitely, and this is what I was talking about, you know, this cover is pretty awesome. Look at this, pretty awesome cover. But in Xbox version, it is green here, like green lines, and it's ugly as hell. But you know, it doesn't matter, it's all about the game. The game is definitely awesome. Okay, so this is it for the games I've got this month from June. I hope you guys enjoy it. Yes, you do not see Arcana Hearts. Arcana Hearts 3 has been delayed in Europe 5 freaking weeks till 19th of August. So, of my knowing, in July, actually nothing comes out. No, nothing comes out in July. Oh yeah, of course, the Aggress of War, Zero, and what's that, Catherine, but it's all like in the end of July. Like Catherine is in America coming like 26th of July, but I'll definitely get the game. So definitely two games will be coming out in July. So maybe I will play more of those games I have, and I'll definitely try to get some American PSP games and maybe some. And I'm like looking forward to Shadow of the Damned. Maybe I'll get that game. Don't know. But definitely see you next time. I hope you enjoyed this video. And you know, see you next time. I said it 4 times or 3 times.